When kindled your interest in mathematics?
Probably at the age of 12. I was very lucky to get a very good teacher in middle school. I would say that behind every scientific career, there is a teacher. The teacher is a central person. My teacher was very encouraging, very supportive. And then I noticed that I like to think about mathematical problems. And I knew that I would try to enter the university and so on. Still very fondly remember her, very gratefully. Beauty of doing that. I like it. There is also elements of sports. When many people are trying to solve some problem, there is an element of sports.
Right.
Well, that will take at least a couple of minutes. All objects have symmetries. Whether we look at ornaments at the old royal palace near City Hall, or ornaments in Alhambra, or elementary particles, they all have symmetries. And all the symmetries follow the same rules. So symmetries of royal palace are the same as symmetries of elementary particles. And these symmetries are studied by group theory, a mathematical subject. At the beginning of 20th century, Cambridge mathematician William Burnside made some conjectures about the boundary between finite symmetries and infinite symmetries, and that's what I have been working on, boundary between finite and infinite for symmetries. Well, it happens all the time. Mathematicians, they think about a problem all the time, 24 hours, 7 days a week. It is always with me, subconsciously. So when I read a book, or watch a movie, or listen to music, or sleep, I still keep working on it. And the idea may come at absolutely any moment. So what helps to get these ideas is to work non-stop. At some point, when you have been thinking about it for a long time, you no longer need paper. You see everything. Mathematics has dual nature. It is science, and very useful science, but it is also art. If you listen to conversation between two mathematicians, they will say, oh, that is beautiful, that is ugly. How do mathematicians recognize beauty? It's impossible to explain. It's because they read the works of great masters. In the same way as students of art institutes, they first copy paintings of great artists just to develop taste. And musical students, they listen to classical music to know what is beautiful. In the same way with mathematicians. It's a very strange art, I would say, because millions of people can enjoy a painting. With some mathematical works, maybe 100 people can enjoy. And it is impossible to distinguish artistic part from the useful part. They are the same whole. They are undividable. I would say never in history mathematics enjoyed such prestige in the society as it does now. Life becomes more and more digital, and that goes through mathematics. Each time when you log into your email account, or listen to any music, or get money from ATM machine, you use non-trivial mathematics. And as time goes, there will be more and more of that. Oh, well, I like many things. I like to travel. I like to meet friends, to read, to eat. Well, first of all, for those who are interested in mathematics, especially young people, thank you for being interested. A little advice, try to be active. It's very boring just to learn what other people have done. Try to solve problems, try to do exercises, try to do something.